Hey guys, just starting the vlog off, and it's actually 3 o'clock and I'm just now really getting my Saturday started. I did wash my hair, I washed the dishes, I vacuumed, and now I'm gonna go run some errands outside of the house. It took me a little minute to get my day started because I really thought today was gonna be a sleep and stay in bed all day, but I was like, I gotta get stuff done. So, gonna put on my socks and slides and get on into the car. We're going over to Macy's to pick up an order and see what goes from there. I know I need to make another pineapple upside down cake because the first one I made, it was good, but I feel like I could do better. So I'm gonna make another one. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the car. Just was cranking the 8C all the way here, but I'm about to pull, oh, the camera, it's doing it again. Okay, never mind. So you'll just have to deal with only seeing part of my face, but I'm pulling into the Macy's, or basically the mall parking lot, and I'm going over to the Macy's entrance just so I can pick up my item. And the idea is to go to Jack in the Box because they have a pineapple milkshake I want to try. They probably don't have it anymore because I waited too long to go get it, but it doesn't hurt to go check, you know? You know? I think the store pickup is in that lane. I need to get over. I am going out to dinner tonight. It's like Cincinnati Restaurant Week, and so I think it's also Asian Food Week. So I was gonna go to this restaurant and they're having a bunch of like really cool looking Asian foods, including, what do you have this box here for? People, ooh. So the curbside pickup, it looks like somebody picked up their item, opened up the box, and then threw the box in the parking lot is what it looks like happened. It's just like, you people are disgusting. How could you? Anyway, they have the Korean cheese dogs and I really want to try one. So that's the main reason I want to go to this restaurant. It's like a 5-course meal situation. But let me run in and get my item and then get back out because for whatever reason, it's 86 degrees and I wore a sweatshirt. Mostly because I didn't know what the temperature was when, can I do curbside pickup? I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna go in. It's fine. I know they're busy, but yeah, I didn't know it was 86 degrees when I got dressed today. So, okay. Package secured and it's so hot. Okay, let's go to Jack in the Box, see if they have this shake, and then we're gonna go back home because it's dangerous out here, man. It's hot. All right, luckily it's only 11 minutes away. Oof, it is hot. Yeah, I am not gonna make it in this sweatshirt, so yeah, let's rush home. People's driving today is working my nerves. Jumping right out in front of you, turn signals on at the last minute, driving super fast in parking lots, like, you're driving me to homicide. But we're almost to Jack in the Box. I really hope they have this shake because I really want to try it. I should have went and got it days ago, but I just couldn't work myself into it because it was like, well, if I go get it, I have to vlog it. If I vlog it, that means I should probably wash my face. But do you feel like washing your face? No, so I didn't end up doing it. But now I'm out and about, my face is washed, my hair is clean. So I guess now I have the tools needed to do it. I saw The Northman yesterday at the movie theater and it was so good. Like, I won't say it was so good. It was good though. It was good. It was worth watching. It didn't give me the feels, so I wouldn't like rewatch it or buy it, but it was a good watch just because it had a bunch of good people in it. Yeah. It's almost time for Multiverse of Madness. That's what I'm really excited about. I have to see when that comes out. It has to be like very soon, like next week, the week after, something like that. I still haven't bought my ticket, so obviously I'm playing with fire. All right, Jack in the Box. Fingers crossed they have this pineapple shake. Hey, when you go places and the line is wrapped around the building, it's like, whoa, what's happening? I see no advertising. They start advertising the mint shake. Maybe once I drive around, they better not be like, oh, actually, our shake machine is down. Sorry, not sorry. Somebody's license plate is Daddy, but it's D-A-H-D-E-E. That has to be Daddy, right? Weird. There are like four cars in front of me to even order, so I guess I'll be back because I don't want to run off the battery and have a bunch of footage of me just sitting in the car. Okay, it's my turn to order.
I just have a question. Do you guys have the pineapple milkshake?
Okay, thank you. Waited all that time just for them to be sold out. How annoying is that? I should have came earlier in the week, but whatever. I'm just gonna go home. It wasn't even worth getting anything else.
I changed into something a little bit more warm weather appropriate.
Even an iced coffee, it sounded so good, but not worth the wait. So I'm just gonna go home and change out of this sweatshirt because it's way too hot for a sweatshirt.
Popping in to do a voiceover. This is actually later on that same day. I have these cute dress, my Rihanna Pumas, and I have my hair in these little butterfly clips with the blue eyeshadow, which I love so much. I love this hairstyle. First course was a salad, which was super good. I would eat this salad all the time. One of the best things I got. And the other was a chicken and seafood gumbo. These are some Korean fried cheeses and they were so salty. The other thing was like a shrimp taco. It had rice, kimchi, some sprouts, and a lettuce wrap. It was good, but those fried cheeses were so salty. Some were burnt. Kind of disappointed because I was looking forward to those the most out of everything. This is a chicken and waffles with cayenne syrup and a crispy cod slider. Waffle was like really doughy and weird. I don't know how you mess up a waffle, but go off. These were the worst courses here. This is literally boiled chicken and rice. So heated, because how do you serve people boiled chicken and rice? How? The dessert was the best. That brownie peanut butter situation, so good. The ice cream thing next to it was supposed to be hollow, but it was not shaved ice. It was like crushed ice, so not good. I wanted to get this clip of the streetcar because I haven't seen it up close yet, but it's so cute. I haven't rode it yet, and I know it's been here forever in my city, but one of these days. Went to this ice cream place, and I just was really interested because they kept using dry ice, and it looked very intense to make milkshakes. Like, those girls are back there grinding, making milkshakes. As I'm going through my footage, I see I actually was taking some videos while I was trying out clothes in H&M a couple weekends ago. I don't even remember everything that I bought, but I figured I'd go ahead and throw in the footage of me trying on things. This shirt I do remember buying because it's so cute. It's an extra small, but I think it's supposed to be oversized, and I just thought it was like really cute. Just big button up. Pink sweater. I believe I have this sweater in black. I thought it looked cute with the skirt, so I was just like sold. Pretty sure I bought that. Like, some things I do remember. Big sweater. I have so many black sweaters that I was just like, do I really need this? Is this really necessary? Do you need a fifth black button-up sweater? The answer is yes, but the answer is no. This dress I really wanted to like because it has that kind of scrunchy thing on the top. It didn't have pockets. the length. I don't know. I feel like maybe if I wore the right shoes, this would be really cute. It just feels like, oh, I'm going to wear a cute hat and I'm going to have a picnic. It's going to be adorable in my dress, was kind of the vibe I was feeling. But I think I just didn't have the right shoes and I just felt like a blob in it. This shirt I really like. I don't know if I got it. I don't know. I have to look. But I also think I'm trying on the pants. I don't think those are my pants. No, because I wore a skirt. Little puff sleeves and skinny jeans. I don't remember if I like them. This is just another shirt and those same jeans, I believe. Again, it's been several days, so I don't remember. This jacket coat thing, I really wanted it because I thought it was just really cool next time, like winter time this year. I was going to be able to wear a cute plaid button-up situation, but it was so scratchy that I was just like, it's not worth it. I could probably find something that feels a lot better on my skin elsewhere. Another pair of pants, actually. I didn't like the way they fitted. I wanted to like those pants because I'm like, oh, bell-bottom, how much fun, but they made me look not neat, and I was just like, that's not the vibe. This dress. Why does it have these fake built-in hip things? Who is this dress for? Maybe it's for people who are actually like hippie like that, but it was like super loose on the top.
Quick little insert because I'm not sure where this footage is going, but I'm kind of disgusted because I just bought this queso and the lid of it is like extra grimy. But I bought a bunch of quesos and I want to come in here and try all of them so I can figure out which brand has the best store queso, because I'm tired of going to Chipotle and constantly buying their queso because it's so good. So I got four different kinds. I'm gonna heat them up and then we're gonna try them to figure out who has the best store queso and go from there. I know the Hordez, I've had this one in the past and I really liked it, but when I googled it, it said this one was the best. And then I saw that Target had one that had a really good like rating, so I got that. And then I had to go to the refrigerator aisle in Kroger's and get one that's actually refrigerated because it would most likely be the most real cheese. Let's get these heated up and we're gonna go ahead and try all of them because I really wanna eat chips and cheese, but I also need some content. So that's what we're doing here. Ugh. Hold on, I'm struggling to get these open. I'll be back after all the heated up and open. Okay, we have all the cheeses out and we're gonna try them. Let's start with my tried and true, the Hordez Queso Blanco Dip in medium. And I'm just trying all the chips, which is some regular plain tortilla chips. The texture of this one is definitely my favorite. This one is good. Okay. Next, let's try the Queso Blanco Private Selection. This one is also medium. This one was from the refrigerated section in Kroger's. This one's the thickest. This tastes pretty good too. I just don't think it's weird how they're calling it Blanco and it's like obviously kind of dark, so, but that one tastes good too. Next up is the On the Border Monterey Jack queso. Kind of hard to decide. Next is the Good and Gather Queso Blanco. This one is mild. They all taste very similar. Honestly, I still think this one's my favorite. The Hordez. This one might be my favorite. It has a good amount of heat, but it's not too hot where it's unbearable. The Tarkin one is pretty good too, but again, it's definitely dark. It's not as like Blanco like the other ones say. This one might be next. The Target. Good and Gather. Wait a minute. This one might actually be second. It might even be first. I don't know. This Kroger one is pretty good. All right, I guess that would put the On the Border one in fourth place, even though this was the top rated one on the internet, but it was going against things like Tostitos and stuff like that. Like, it didn't go against any of these brands. All right, and then while we're at it, I have something else to try. Flaming Hot Mountain Dew. I'm gonna go ahead and try this because if I'm not trying it on camera, then it's not worth it, is what I always think to myself now. This just tastes like lime. Is this just lime? Mountain Dew with a blast of heat and citrus. I feel like there's like a heated aftertaste like in the back of my throat, but I mostly taste the lime. This is good. It's fine. It's just extra limey Mountain Dew. Mountain Dew is already lemon lime. So you can just taste the extra lime with that little bit of heat that kind of just sits in your throat back here, but it's not unbearable. I'm not even like a Mountain Dew drinker unless it's like a slushy, but I like it. Okay, I'm actually gonna heat up probably more queso. I'm gonna heat these quesos up a little bit more and probably, I don't know, like why do I wanna eat this one? Maybe this one is my favorite. This one might be the better one. I think I lied. I think the Private Selection might be the better one. I like this one. And I got it from the refrigerator section too, so it probably has a little less poison in it than the other one, so yay. I'm gonna close these up and lay on the couch and eat my queso. See you guys in the next clip. I was not meaning to start another vlog or continue this vlog. Now, it's been several days since the last couple clips and it's actually 5:55. I'm in the kitchen, a little bit annoyed because I had an appointment. Well, I didn't have an appointment. I called this place and they're like, yeah, we do walk-ins, come in. So I come in for a walk-in and they're like, sorry, we don't do walk-ins, we're busy. And I'm just like, I left work on time instead of staying and doing some compliance classes like I need to. And I hopped in after work traffic to come here because you guys told me you do walk-ins and then I show up and you don't do walk-ins. Rage. So I snatch my ID off the counter and I turn away real abruptly and I walk right on out of there. But yeah, now I'm back at home. And I need to make another pineapple upside down cake because the other cake I made didn't turn out the way that I want it to. Granted, it was the first-ish pineapple upside down cake I ever made, so now I know what I need to improve on. So I'll go ahead and insert that footage because I've been sitting on it. I was gonna insert it into another video, but since it's pineapple upside down redemption day, we're gonna make another cake and I'll include like parts that I'm doing differently because you don't need to see me make the same cake twice. Like you just don't. I am right now about to make something to eat. I got a slushy. I went to the Thornton's on the annoying side of town and
I open up the door to go in, and this lady just comes right, like, let me start. So the gas station, there's two doors, in and out, you know, keep traffic going. There's one door you go in, one door you go out. So there's a lady coming, she's like walking towards the door, the outdoor. So I go ahead and open up the indoor because I'm going in. She then comes through the door that I'm trying to walk through. Thank you. I wasn't opening up this door for you, ma'am. That was for me. But that might have just been my bad attitude thing, like talking. But in reality, like, if I was opening up the door for you, I would have opened it and then stood back, not opened it and continued to step through it. Like, don't make me be nice to you. I didn't ask to do all that. I have a pan sitting here. Let's just sit down because I started to make myself some ramen because I got this fancy looking ramen. And it's from Nissin. Like, I don't know, I'm pretty sure this is like a normal brand, but it's like a fancy kind of looking ramen. And I like the tonkatsu flavor. So I bought this for that, but I'm actually gonna save it for another day because I did just make some jalapeno poppers. I'm gonna eat those and I'm gonna go ahead and sit down and start making that cake because I need to edit a video. On top of needing to edit a video, let me show you my pile that's growing of packages. We got a nice little stack growing here. And then there's a pair of shoes over there that I did open because I wanted to look at them. But yeah. And the reason why there's a pile is because now it's like if I'm going to open up a package, I might as well do it on camera. So if I'm not recording anything, there's no point in me opening up the package, you know? So maybe this week I will, I swear my hair looked really good earlier today and now it just looks like funny. I'll get to opening up those packages, going through those clothes. I think I'm waiting on one more clothes package, but I don't think it's coming to the 4th. Is the 4th Friday? When is the 4th? Is that next week? Yeah, that's next week. Hopefully it comes sooner than that. I have one more item coming on the 4th and I wanted to try on everything all at once, but I may just try on this stuff for the footage, sit on the footage until I get the next item and then do it again, like just try on the next piece. That way I'm going through the stuff and putting them on, figure out what fits before it gets too late, before to send things back. I'm pretty sure those jalapeno poppers are done cooling down. I'm gonna gather up all my cake ingredients and we're gonna sit down and make another cake. All right, sitting here with all my mess and my jalapeno poppers. They look really good. Ooh. One fell. They look really good. I'm scared it's gonna be entirely too hot. These are good. I don't remember where I got them from. I think Kroger's. I'm gonna finish eating these, drink some more of my slushy, make this cake mix. I don't know. I'll finish eating these and I'll be right back so that we can get this cake together. Because I do want to edit this video today. It's 6:08. I want to get this done today. Okay, moving some things out of the way because now I have a clear idea on what I did wrong and what I'm gonna do differently this time. So first, I did go ahead and melt a whole stick of butter and I'm gonna make a brown sugar slurry kind of situation to put at the bottom of the pineapple upside down cake because I personally liked how it wasn't super sweet and the only sweetness you were getting was from like the cherries and the cake mix, but turns out you're supposed to put a little bit more sugar in it. So we're gonna make a nice brown sugar kind of like, I don't know, mixture for the bottom. I don't know, I kind of feel like maybe this wasn't enough sugar. Oh,
So this just feels crazy. Like, so much butter. That's a lot. Like, I'm full of regret right now. And it's too late to do anything about it. Maybe I'll just drip some of the butter into the container that I'm using, because I do need to butter the dish. It just feels like a lot of butter, you know. Grease the sides with the butter. All right, we got some butter in this one. I don't know how much you guys can actually see because I have so much stuff in the way. I guess I can move some things out of the way, but you know, who has the time? This is a lot of butter. I feel so bad about this, because I feel like the first cake I made, I didn't put enough butter, and now I feel like for this one, I put too much butter. And this was the good butter, so I kind of feel bad, like I'm wasting it or something. Just gonna put one of the cans of pineapple inside of this container. Ooh, oh, wait, it's overflowing. Ah, I made a mistake. Ugh, I'm making a mess. I just wanted to be able to pour some of the excess butter into something. Now I have a decent, like, brown sugar slurry situation. And also just a mess in the bottom of this pan. I'm so disgusted. I'm not doing this. I'm pouring some of this out. Like, there's just no way. Next time I would just do half a stick of butter, because that's insane. A whole stick of butter. And we're just gonna pour our brown sugar situation at the bottom of this. And then I'm gonna pour, actually gonna pour out some of this butter into the pan, this other can, and pour this brown sugar in there. All right, we had our brown sugar situations at the bottom of the pans now. I'm gonna go ahead and move the brown sugar because I know it's in the way. And now, I don't have a fork, but we can start getting some of this pineapple out of here. This is a mess. Like, my table is a mess. Let's just do that. What else is just sitting here? I don't know. I'm done looking at it. Let's just get this done. We're just gonna plop a lot of pineapple done, because before, in my opinion, it just was not enough topping. So this is about a can and a half of topping. I have a potential spam number calling me, so I will not be picking that up, because spam, gross. Okay. There's all that pineapple, and then I'm gonna go in with the other can and grab more, just to get a nice, good layer of pineapple done down. I also use pineapple in fruit juice instead of the heavy syrup, so the actual pineapple that I'm putting on is not as sweet. I think that is plenty. Like, that has to be enough. At this point, this is like two full cans of pineapple. The half a can I had before, if anything, maybe this one can use a little bit more pineapple, just so it's like an even layer. I need to clean up my workstation and then possibly go ahead and turn on the stove to preheat. And then when I come back, we're gonna put the cherries in, but my workstation is hellish. And I can't work like this. Let me clean up really quick. All right, so everything is slightly more cleaned up, and I did go ahead and put the cherries in. This is about a full jar of, a full jar of cherries and about half a jar of my old thing of cherries. So we have all our cherries lined up, and now I'm gonna mix up my cake mix. Because this is like the easy part, because now the oven is preheated, my kitchen space is clean. I'm like, can you guys even see what I'm doing? But I believe you can. Cake mix, 3 eggs. How have you guys been? I'm like still trying to get a grasp on time. I don't know why it just feels like I'm trying to think back, and I just feel like I used to have so much time in my day to do so much, and now it's like I blink and I sit down for a second and the whole day is gone, and it's like, well, what did you do? What have you done today? Like, what do you have to show for what you've done today? And I'm just like, absolutely nothing. Because it's about to be 7 o'clock now. I literally started recording this video at 5 and it's 7 and I've made a cake and I ate some jalapeno poppers. What? 1 cup of water, 1/2 cup of vegetable oil. Even at work, like I'm sitting at my desk at work, I'm getting stuff done and I'm thinking, okay, I'm gonna get done with all my cases early today so I can go work on something else and do all these other things. And then I look up and it's 3:30 and I'm like, oh crap, it's almost time to go and I still have so much to do. Like, is that just how it is in life? Once you reach a certain point, it just flies by and you're just trying to catch up the whole time? Because I don't like that. Okay, well maybe don't turn it up so high. Feel pretty good about that. The only thing that has me kind of nervous is that the cherries say may contain pits, and I'm just like, ooh, what if I make this cake and then I go to bite in a piece and I get a little too crazy and I bite too hard on a cherry pit? That sounds awful. Also, like, what if my hair is in something? Like, I hope not. That'd be just embarrassing. Not so much for the cake that I'm making for myself, but morely like the cake I'm making for my grandma. What if it has a cherry pit? What if my hair's in it? I don't see any hair, but you never know. Would they be too polite and not say anything to me? And they just secretly don't want to eat anything I ever give them ever again? You know? But let's get to divvying out the cake mix. Like, can you guys see anything? Yeah, you can. Do a nice layer there. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do a nice layer on this cake. But most of the mix needs to go in this one. It feels like such a thin layer of cake mix. Like, maybe I should have made more, but I also know it's gonna rise, so maybe it is okay. Okay, I'm gonna plop these in the oven and I will be actually starting to edit this video while these are cooking, and then I'll pop back in when these are done. Hopefully I don't forget like I did last time. But okay, time to try the cakes, or try one of the cakes. I don't know why I turned into a crazy person and was just stabbing at this one so willy-nilly to the point where I made a hole. I temporarily lost my mind, apparently. This one, I also, like, this is a cake I'm giving to someone. Why am I stabbing it this way? They look good. Let's go ahead and try one. This one that I'm keeping. Let's try it. They're hot still. I'm just gonna. Cherry juice is leaking everywhere. I need a napkin. I don't like warm cake. That's my only right now, is that it's still warm. But that's good. I did put a little in that.
I don't know what I do with my lids. I think once I put the lid on it and it kind of sits there and steams a little bit, the cake can retain a little bit more moisture, because to me the edges are a little overcooked because of the center. Like, I put so many liquids in there that it was hard for the center of the cake. Like, it took forever for that centerpiece to fully cook. When I end up having to leave it in there for an additional 20 minutes when I would have wanted to take it out when the cake was still, like, really light. But it's okay. Maybe once it sits in the fridge, it sits in its own juices, it'll soften up a little bit. But the cake is good. I'll be eating on this all week along with everything else that I have. Let me wash my hands because they're covered in cherry juice. Okay, now I'm sitting on the floor by my laptop. I don't know if you guys can hear it, heavy breathing, but it's trying its best. I actually am doing pretty good. It's 9:23 and I am pretty much done editing this video. I just have to add the bits that I'm recording now, go ahead and add those, edit them, and then I will be done with the vlog that you guys will be seeing the day you're seeing it. Actually, the day you'll be seeing this will be my grandma's birthday, so she's actually getting that other cake. I'm not sure if we're doing anything that day. Usually plans in my family are not made until the day of, because we're all a day of, we'll see what we do, we'll see how we feel kind of family. Just waiting for my aunt to text me back and verify if anything's happening, because if not, I'll just drop the cake off at the house after work and I'll come on home after I sit with her for a little bit, of course, for her birthday, because she's a cutie pie. I'm also realizing while I was editing that footage at the food week when I was showing the dishes, because I was so nervous that I was like out in public trying to record like in a restaurant, that I felt super self-conscious that I would hurry up, try to take a little clip of the food, and then I would hurry and put my phone back down so that people won't be like, wow, what are you doing? So now I know I need to make sure I'm getting longer clips of foods, like B-roll. I need to do better with my B-roll, because the clips I had were so short, and when I was trying to do my commentary on them, I would have to talk so fast or cut stuff out of the commentary because it was such a short clip. Like, what am I supposed to do? Hopefully this week. I don't know what I'm doing this week. I want to start decorating on my bathroom so I can open up these packages, but I don't know. I'm also having decorating somebody else's bedroom because their bedroom needed some assistance. So I wanted to do like a before and after kind of video decorating kind of situation. But I don't know about that. We'll see what happens. Is that all I had to say? I've been playing a lot of that Cat Cafe Manager game. I love it. Because I'm still waiting on Baron Breakfast. Apparently I'll be waiting for the rest of my life for Baron Breakfast. Still hasn't come out. And my Steam Deck projection date, like the delivery date, I knew I wasn't tripping with the date. Like my date, first I was in quarter one. Then I was like, okay, this is me. And then I check it, now I'm quarter two. And now I'm in quarter three. I watched a video and some people were saying that their dates were getting pushed back too. And I'm like, I knew it wasn't just me. I don't understand. Like, I don't know. It is what it is. I probably won't be playing the Steam Deck that much, but I just wanted to have it because I know a lot of those cute cafe or little games are usually just on PC or Steam only. And I just wanted to have it, okay? I wanted it. But I guess whenever it does pop up, it's my turn to go ahead and get it. Here's doing something weird right there. I do have to go into the office tomorrow, so I probably should be wrapping it up and getting to bed soon because it's about to be 9:30. It's probably gonna take about an hour and a half for this video to save. And I wanna make sure it's going up to YouTube and I have my thumbnail created tonight so that tomorrow I can get to work on time so I can leave on time. But if you made it this far, leave a pineapple emoji and I will see you guys in the next vlog. Not sure what kind of vlog it's gonna be, but we'll see.
Bye, you guys.
Special shout out to the channel members. Thank you so much for your support.